Good morning, everyone. I know we're excited to be together, but if you could all take your seats, I would deeply appreciate it so we can get started with our State of the Schools. Good morning, and thank you for being here for the 2021 Orange County Public Schools State of the Schools. After a year hiatus, it's nice to see you all in person, and I know that you're very happy to see each other. At this time, we would like to introduce the Dr. Phillips High School Air Force Junior ROTC, directed by Lieutenant Colonel Richard Proctor, to present the colors of our nation. Thank you for standing, and now the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Please continue standing and let me introduce the talented singer from Dr. Phillips High School, Natalie Mistali, who will lead us in singing the national anthem. After the anthem, please remain standing while the colors are retired. Natalie. Thank you. Please be seated. Before we continue, as it was Veterans Day yesterday, and of course our students remind us how proud we are of our nation, could I ask any veterans in this room to stand, please, and be recognized? Thank you so much for your service. Next, our invocation will be led by the Reverend Dr. Gabriel Salguera, lead pastor at the Gathering Place and the president of the National Latino Evangelical Coalition. Pastor?
Let us pray. God of our weary years, we have come through some challenging and difficult times, but you have held our hand. You have seen us through. You are seeing us through. And so in this moment, we give you a prayer of thanksgiving for your dependability, because you have sustained us and you are sustaining us. But God, we also come beseeching you for the ecosystem of Orange County Public Schools, its administrators, its teachers, its students, its parents, its staff. We ask you, God, for the gifts of wisdom so we can teach rightly, for the gifts of kindness so we can relate generously, for the gifts of stewardship so we can manage facilities and buildings and relationships circumspectly. In all these things, we depend totally and utterly on you. And as we move forward in this next academic year, bring us to new heights for the benefits of the students, the staff, the parents, and the entire ecosystem. And this I pray in the name of the one the ancients called Wonderful, Counselor, Mighty God, Prince of Peace. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome to the stage Central Florida Hotel and Lodging Association's President and CEO, Robert Agusa.
Well, good morning, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome on this Friday morning. We are so delighted to see you here today and join us. And on behalf of the Central Florida Hotel and Lodging Association, I would like to personally welcome you to the 2021 Orange County Public Schools State of the Schools Address. CFHLA is proud to once again support this annual event, as well as our longstanding partnership and commitment to the success of the Adopt a School program here in Orange County. In total, 58 of our CFHLA lodging and allied members have stepped up in a big way to support this year's Adopt a School program, which features a commitment to at least three activities that can range from school supply drives, teacher appreciation, to sponsoring field trips and educational award programs. On behalf of CFHLA, I'd like to thank each of our members for their continued partnership and support of our Orange County Public Schools. Now at this time, it's my distinct privilege to officially welcome several of our locally elected officials here from Central Florida. And those who are in attendance, as I call your name, I invite each of you to stand and remain standing so that we may collectively acknowledge each of these individuals at the conclusion of the introductions. From the state of Florida, State Representative Camilla Brown, District 45. From Orange County Mayor, Mayor Jerry Demings. Orange County Commissioner, District 3, Myra Uribe. Orange County Comptroller, Phil Diamond. Orange County Supervisor of Elections, Bill Cowles. Orange County Tax Collector, Scott Randolph. From the City of Orlando, Commissioner, District 1, Jim Gray. From the Orange County School Board, our School Board Chair, Teresa Jacobs. Orange County School Board Vice Chair, Pam Gould. Orange County School Board, District 1, Angie Gallo. Orange County School Board, District 2, Johanna Lopez. Orange County School Board, District 3, Linda Cobert. Orange County School Board District 5, Vicki Elaine Felder. Orange County School Board District 6, Karen Castor Dental. And lastly, Orange County School Board District 7, Melissa Bird. I just want to give a round of applause and say thank you to each of these distinguished Central Florida elected leaders. And now it's my distinct privilege to recognize the following businesses and organizations for their sponsorship of today's address. First, please join me in thanking our featured sponsors, including Ripley's Believe It or Not, Orlando, the University of Central Florida, Wells Fargo, and Wharton Smith. Please, let's join us and give them a round of applause. And next, I'd like to join me in thanking our community partners for their support of today's event, including Addition Financial, Advent Health Orlando, Belfour Property Restoration, Core Construction, CPPI, Elevate Orlando, the Greater Orlando Builders Association, Orlando Health, OUC, and Summit Broadband. Let's give them a round of applause. Thank you to each of our sponsors for your continuous support and your support of today's address. And now it's my pleasure to welcome back to the stage Orange County School Board Vice Chair Pam Gould.
Thank you, Robert, members of the CFHLA, and the rest of our sponsors for your continued support of Orange County Public Schools. And special thanks this morning to our hosts, the DoubleTree by Hilton at the entrance to Universal Orlando. That has got to be the longest name ever, but a very valuable one. Before we get to our main event, I would also like to introduce a special few guests that are here this morning. Please stand as I call your names. This is our 2021 Stellar Award winners, OCPS Teacher of the Year, Stuart Parker, and Mr. Parker is an AP Human Geography teacher at Winter Park High 9th Grade Center. Support Person of the Year, Lydia Folks, Secretary Bookkeeper at Blankner. Principal of the Year, Jennifer Bellinger, former principal at Oak Ridge High, but now our district's Minority Achievement Officer. And Assistant Principal of the Year, Rebecca Yedvobenik. Oh, yay, she gave me a thumbs up. Who is now the principal at Ridgewood Park Elementary School. A round of applause, please. I also want to introduce another special friend and partner to OCPS, Ron Pollard, president of the Orange Educator Support Professionals Association. Ron has dedicated many years to ensuring that we not only work together, we don't always agree, but we work together, and is always here for the best interest of our students. He's been a pleasure to work with. As you will hear in just a few minutes, our community is essential to the mission. And with that, I would like to highlight one of our most proud and major supporters, led by Scott Howitt, Chief Communications Officer and the President of the Foundation for Orange County Public Schools, and my fellow Foundation board members. Could you all please stand, Foundation board members, as we recognize your dedication? Thank It truly does take a village and a lot of different companies and individuals who are dedicated to the service and commitment of bettering our students. So it's been a pleasure to serve with this group of people who have made such an impact in Orange County Public Schools. Also, please welcome Melody Williams, president of the Orange County Council PTA and PTSA, and its officers and board members. Melanie, you also have been an amazing partner for years, and she was one of my moms at Metro West. And now it is my honor to introduce to you our featured speaker, the chair of Orange County Public Schools, Teresa Jacobs.
Good morning. It's my distinct pleasure and honor, along with our superintendent, Dr. Barbara Jenkins, and our deputy superintendent, Dr. Maria Vasquez, to present our 2021 State of the Schools Address. Among us this morning are students, families, employees, community members, business partners, and best of all, good friends, longtime friends. It's wonderful to see so many people here that I know so well, that have spent years supporting Orange County Public Schools and helping us lead our students to success. This annual gathering began in 2011 under the leadership of Chairman Bill Sublett, my good friend, and Superintendent Ronald Blocker. Its purpose was to provide our community with an honest appraisal of the district and to celebrate the achievements from the previous year. At that time, Orange County Public Schools included 179,040 students, 21,772 employees, and 180 schools. Wow, have we grown. Today, our more than 24,000 employees are dedicated to supporting the educational needs of more than 206,000 students in 205 schools. Despite this considerable growth, one thing hasn't changed, and that's our unwavering commitment to the success of every student. I'm humbled by this opportunity to continue this tradition as we take you on a journey that highlights who we are, where we've been, what we're doing well, the challenges we face, and with your continued support, where we're going. Additionally, we will share our hopes for the future generation and how together as a community, we will reach our goals. But before I go any further, let me introduce to you someone who, through her passion, commitment, and determination, has been a guiding light through these last 9 years, our esteemed superintendent and my friend, Dr. Barbara Jenkins.
Thank you, Chair. Just a couple of remarks. Let me first ask all of my cabinet to stand. Couldn't do this work without a phenomenal leadership team. I want you to see who they are. OCPS leadership team cabinet. Thank you for all you do. Secondly, this caricature over here, Chair may not have been able to see it because it was at that entrance, was actually done by Bruno Riberin, who is one of our teachers, an art teacher at Endeavor Elementary School. It was displayed at the art teachers, Scott Evans puts on an art show for an organization, and it was displayed there, and they sent me the picture, and I had to have it, Chair, so I actually purchased it, and we'll consider getting a copy for you. But that is the original by Bruno Riberin. It is just amazing to see you all here. It has been a while. That whole pandemic thing has just made our lives different. So I also want to thank you for coming. It is certainly not something you had to do for being here this morning. I want to thank you. Now let me speak to the elephant in the room. I got here this morning. First thing Mayor Deming said to me was, I almost didn't recognize you. So the elephant in the room is, yes, I have had about 12 different hairdos since the pandemic. But I want you to understand, there's a method to my madness, and only my hairdresser knows the whole story. But you've forgotten, when we first went into that lockdown, Mayor, the beauty shops were closed. And some true hair colors started coming through. And then once you start experimenting, it just gets to be fun. And I realized something, this is important, women. anybody actually, you can get away with just about anything during a pandemic. So we're here for a special opportunity to share with you our state of the schools. Last time we gathered was in 2019, and so much has happened since then. It sometimes seems like it's the distant past, and other times it seems like yesterday. Let me refresh your memory. During 2019-20 school year, we were celebrating three big anniversaries. Our momentous milestone of the district's first 150 years of leading students to success. In fact, Scott Howard and his team had planned a great celebration. Didn't happen. Foundation for OCPS also hosted its 20th for our school's golf tournament, providing additional support to Orange County students and teachers. And the district welcomed the 10th cohort of Leadership Orange.
You know, I don't know about any of y'all, but I'm kind of curious when Dr. Jenkins mentioned hair colors coming through, exactly who she was referring to. I'm just gonna leave it at that, but there's lots of possibilities. At that same time, we unveiled our re-envisioned, they're just now figuring it out, our re-envisioned strategic plan, OCPS 2025. As the ninth largest school district in the country, we're responsible for cultivating the next generation of teachers, healthcare professionals, scientists, engineers, coders, and so many other critical professions, some of which we don't even know about yet. So our focus and commitment is paramount to the success of our local community, our state, and our nation. It's for this reason that we're excited to introduce the overarching theme of our strategic plan, our promise, your support, their success. This is a result of months of collaboration with the school board, superintendent, internal departments, and you, our community. The process led by the Research, Accountability, and Grants Department included solicitation of input and feedback from each of these groups, resulting in five revised components of our strategic plan. A plan that will serve as a driving force behind our daily work and the tool by which we measure success.
Our vision is to ensure every child has a promising and successful future. And by every, we mean every. Those from different countries who speak different languages, to those who are gifted and those with severe disabilities. Every child. Recognizing the unique needs of each of our students, we realize it will take all of us outlined in our mission statement. Because 220,000 students and 24,000 employees do the math, we need your help. So with the support of families and the community, we create enriching and diverse pathways to lead our students to success.
Together, our vision and mission reflect not only the commitment of our school district to our students, but our promise to this community. It is critical that we foster trust and pride in OCPS to not only provide high quality education, but also to be a premier local employer of choice. But make no mistake about it, our success as a district depends on your support. The support of our 24,000 employees, our parents and families, and our entire community. Our employees in their respective roles help us create a culture that promotes high expectations for student learning, that focuses on student social and emotional well-being, that cultivates and maintains a dedicated and high-quality team, that creates a positive climate and safe environment, that executes efficient operations, and that creates an engaged and invested community.
For more than 150 years, OCPS has served the educational needs of students in Central Florida. Families have trusted us to educate their children, positioning the district as a leader in public education. You jinxed me. As a leader in public education across the state and the nation. While formal instruction takes place in the classroom, we acknowledge that true learning begins and ends in the home. And so we're grateful for your support as parents and trusted guardians and your involvement in your child's learning at home and on school campuses.
Beyond the role of our employees and our families, community support is also crucial to ensuring student success. Resources provided by our admissions volunteers and partners in education are essential to our ability to meet the needs of students each and every day. Prior to the pandemic, more than 56,000 individuals and 2,600 businesses volunteered their time, talent, and treasures. We also engage representatives of our community, as well as organization and business leaders, to serve on various district committees, including the Audit Advisory Committee, the Citizens Construction Oversight and Value Engineering Committee, our Faith-Based Advisory Council, our K-12 Mental Health Commission, our Medical Advisory Committee, and our Unitary Status Committee. If there are any members of these groups in the room with us this morning, would you please stand so we can recognize you? These individuals offer invaluable insight regarding the decisions to be made on behalf of the district, and they help us ensure transparency and accountability.
You may begin to notice a common theme emerging: student success. Ensuring their success is our core business and primary focus. Now, our market differentiators are what set us apart from the competition. There are several. They include offering the highest quality academic, arts, and extracurricular activities, providing learning in state-of-the-art facilities, being an innovator in digital learning, operational excellence and community support, being a leader in career and technical education, offering extensive choices and unique learning opportunities, being transparent and accountable to our stakeholders, and embracing and celebrating a diverse community. As a school district, we also hold our students and employees to the following values: equity, integrity, inclusion, collaboration, respect, and innovation. These values reflect our culture and what we stand for. Now that we've provided an understanding of the framework that guides our work and core business, let's take a look at an overview of the district as a whole in this short video.
Central Florida's Orange County Public Schools is one of the nation's largest school districts. We serve a culturally diverse student body of more than 206,000 students who represent nearly 208 countries and speak more than 166 languages and dialects. Rated an A school district by the Florida Department of Education, Orange County Public Schools, then 20 traditional high schools, achieved a 97.9% graduation rate in 2019-20. At OCPS, you'll find art and music programs in every school, specialized award-winning magnet options beginning in elementary grades, a wide variety of athletic and extracurricular opportunities, and some of the most comprehensive programs for students with special needs, including gifted students. In fact, OCPS screens all second graders for gifted services to ensure that no child's potential is overlooked. Five campuses of Orange Technical College offer training and certification in a variety of high-demand career and technical fields. Through dual enrollment, 6th through 12th graders can take post-secondary coursework while simultaneously earning credit toward high school completion. Thanks to the generous support of our community, OCPS students learn in some of the most modern, state-of-the-art facilities in the country. Since 2003, we've opened 59 new schools and replaced or renovated 132 others as a result of two successful sales tax initiatives. A leader in one-to-one digital learning, OCPS has distributed more than 198,000 devices and nearly 11,000 mobile hotspots to students. As a result of the COVID-19 pandemic, the district accelerated the program in order to achieve the goal of being fully one-to-one for the 2020-21 school year. The program provides continuous access to learning, which increases student engagement and helps close achievement gaps.
Sometimes in school you don't have the amount of time you need to finish a document. And now you can take it home, work on it, finish it as you need to. Our teachers have digital common boards so we can see what we're doing today, tomorrow, what we did last week.
It's made my calculus class a lot easier to understand. It's allowed me to use tools so I can actually see graphs of functions and integrals.
It's definitely made schoolwork more interactive, and I find it much more entertaining. And things that are entertaining help me remember better.
That's a lot that's been accomplished over the years in OCPS. And I want to tell you, although they couldn't all be here today, it's due to an outstanding instructional team, teachers, principals, all of our paraprofessionals, all of our support team, our education support staff. They are all responsible under the great leadership of this dynamic school board for those accomplishments. You see, continuous access to learning has greatly impacted our students for the better. And the COVID-19 pandemic has only reinforced that point. When the pandemic began in the spring of 2020, OCPS had a huge head start on many districts across the country. Not only because of our number of devices, but because of the training we provided to teachers over the previous 5 years. Digital learning was nothing new for many of our teachers and students.
For almost 2 years now, our board, Dr. Jenkins, and her administration have embraced the challenges presented by COVID-19. We started the 2021 school year by providing the safest possible learning environment for our students and families. And like everyone else impacted by the pandemic, we continue to evaluate our learning and working environments. No, we haven't had 100% agreement among our community and staff, but I wholeheartedly believe that our board, along with the superintendent and her administration, are making the best decisions possible under the constraints that we've been faced with. I also want to pause for just a minute to reflect on one thing that I think there is probably nearly 100% agreement on, and that is that all of Dr. Jenkins' 12 different hairstyles have been stunning.
Oh.
I thought you would agree.
I will pay you later. So let me quickly share how our district has made substantial adaptations to educate our students and keep them and our staff safe since the beginning of the pandemic. In March 2020, the entire nation shut down, forcing all schools to close and students to shift to virtual learning. All events were canceled. Remember this? Including senior activities and graduations. That was heartbreaking for the community. But the impact was felt far beyond the classroom. Thousands of students depend on our schools for their nutritional needs during the day. So our phenomenal food and nutrition services team instituted a massive grab-and-go meal distribution network, providing daily breakfast, lunch, and dinner for our students and families. Listen to this number, more than 44 million meals in total were served. And with the help of our transportation services, we made sure that students experiencing homelessness were also fed at hotels, shelters, and other sites. It was quite a feat, and thanks to all of the team members in OCPS. Now, I want to bring up someone else who can share additional information. Anybody here see the Broadway musical Hamilton? So it used to be that, I need my moment. Used to be, Bill Sublette used to try these analogies like, you know, Jenkins is like our quarterback, you know. He wanted me to be a certain quarterback. I think it may have been someone who's in trouble in the NFL now. And I insisted on being either Cam Newton or Tom Brady, because I think there's some similarities between us. This year, I thought about bringing on my deputy superintendent, who is phenomenal. If you haven't met her, I want you to get to know her. And I thought about the Broadway musical Hamilton. I'm actually one of those few people who actually read the whole biography, because I love biographies. I thought about that. And one of my favorite characters in the original Broadway musical is Christopher Jackson, who plays George Washington. So I want to be, for my analogy, George Washington. I love some of the music and some of the performance by George Washington, and by Christopher Hamilton, I should say. And so if I am George Washington this morning, I want you to meet my phenomenal, incredible right-hand man, Dr. Vasquez.
Good morning. During the summer of 2020, based on staff and family survey responses, Our teams worked on various instructional models for the 2021 school year. Parents were able to choose from three learning options: face-to-face, Launch Ed at Home, and Orange County Virtual School. When school began in August 2020, 32% of our students returned to in-person learning. By the end of the school year, that number had risen to 60% face-to-face and 40% Launch Ed at Home. Our Orange County Virtual School enrollment increased by 925%. As we welcome students back to our campuses, keeping our values at the forefront, here are some of the other precautions we instituted. We asked staff and students to maintain 6 feet of social distance as best they could. We hired additional custodial staff to clean and disinfect schools and facilities. We installed MERV 13 air filters in schools, established the Medical Advisory Committee to guide and respond to health-related questions. We developed the COVID-19 Health and Safety Procedures Manual, launched the COVID-19 dashboard accessible to all, implemented a face mask policy, provided PPE to staff and students, offered testing and vaccination opportunities for employees, students, and community members, and to allow for some sort of normalcy, we held sporting and extracurricular activities at a reduced in-person capacity and were able to resume most senior festivities, including graduations. That leads us to this current 2021-22 school year. Based on guidance from the State Board of Education, we were only able to offer students two learning options: face-to-face and Orange County Virtual School. With the exception of a 60-day requirement during the height of the Delta variant surge, students have been required to wear a mask unless parents opt out with a note. Currently, only 8% of our families have done so. As of yesterday, we have now made face masks optional for all employees. I would like to point out that none of what we have accomplished would have been achieved without the willingness, flexibility, and hard work of our exceptional staff at all levels. We acknowledge and thank them for their hard work and commitment during this unprecedented time. Their actions exemplify our district values as outlined earlier. Before I turn the podium back over to Dr. Jenkins, or George Washington as she'd like to be known, I would like to share that these values, coupled with our actions, were recognized this spring during our reaccreditation process from Cognia, formerly known as Advanced Ed. Accreditation is the most widely used and recognized school improvement process worldwide. This ongoing process requires continuous engagement from the district and school leaders. Our accreditation process was comprised of two phases: self-analysis and reflection, an internal examination of areas of improvement, and an external evaluation, an acknowledgement and guidance on how to continue leveraging district strengths to impact our students. The district welcomed 5 weeks of review of provided evidence and 4 days of on-site interviews from 576 people, including community members, students, employees, and district leadership. The organization presented its findings to the school board back in June and stated OCPS had one of the highest scores the organization had encountered worldwide in quite some time. Dr. Mark Elgart of Cognia said, Continuous improvement is deeply embedded in the culture of these schools and school system. It is the language in which people interact every day. It is the actions that people commit to, all for the focus on helping kids succeed. We will continue to use their feedback and recommended areas of opportunity for improvement for the success of our students.
Well, thank you, Hamilton. Thank you for your hard work and your dedication to the students of Orange County. Before we move on, one thing I want to come back and just highlight, because as a still a relative newbie, I've been with the school district now for about 2.5 years, but as you know, I spent many, many years in Orange County government, many years as a citizen advocate, looking for transparency, accountability, looking for the best of the best in government. I want to read one more time Dr. Elgert's comment: continuous improvement is deeply embedded in the culture of these schools and school systems. It is the language in which people interact every day. It is the actions that people commit to, all for the focus of helping kids. I can attest that that is exactly what I've seen joining OCPS from the inside. And it is really remarkable to work in an organization where there's such a commitment to looking really hard at what we're doing, what's working, what's not working, and constantly, constantly seeking to improve, and measuring everything so that we know for certain whether we're attaining our goals or not. It is just awesome and something this community should be enormously proud of. So George Washington Hamilton, great job. I don't know if it's occurred to any of y'all, but I am really curious who the superintendent says I am when she's in her cabinet meetings. I'm hoping most of the time it's a positive character, but I think I'd have to ask maybe some former employees to find out for sure. No, I'm just kidding. We have an incredible relationship. At your seats this morning, you will find our 2021 annual report, in which you can read about the district and many of our accomplishments over the last year. But there are a couple of these that I want to take just a moment to point out. OCPS is one of 7 urban school districts here in Florida. As the 4th largest in the state, our more than 24,000 employees proudly serve students who reflect the diversity of our community, representing 208 countries, speaking 166 dialects. Last year, 75% of our student population qualified for free or reduced meals, an indicator of the level of need here in Orange County.
In spite of the socioeconomic challenges in our region, our students continue to excel. I want you to note these numbers. There will be a test before you exit, and there are no door prizes, but I want you to pay attention nonetheless. Nearly 98% of seniors in our traditional high schools graduated during the 2019-20 school year. Now, if I factor in charter and alternative schools, the number is still extremely high. It's 90.4%. One of my favorite events, I thought you were going to clap when I said 90.4%.
Dr. Jenkins, if you pointed out to them that in 2000 it was less than 50%.
So long ago, less than 50% of our seniors graduated back in 2000. And so it's an incredible feat for our entire community and especially for our teachers and our principals. Wonderful to point that out. So one of my favorite events of the year is our Super Scholar Celebration. This event honors the graduating seniors accepted into the top 20 universities, liberal arts colleges, and U.S. service academies as ranked by U.S. News and World Report. Last year, we virtually recognized 127 graduating seniors from our 20 traditional high schools. Additionally, 26 seniors from 11 high schools were chosen as 2021 National Merit Scholars, while 7 others were semifinalists and also won scholarship awards. Listen to this number. 256 graduating seniors earn their associate's degree from Valencia College, along with their diploma. That's nearly a 25% increase from the previous year. I can't help but detour just for a moment there. We have such wonderful partnership with Valencia and with UCF. I spotted someone who's retiring as Dean of the College of Education. Sissy Carroll, stand up so we can recognize you. I saw you, I spotted you. Thanks to you and all of your colleagues for being here, and thank you for all of your partnership. I actually am indisposed on your actual celebration, but I wanted to publicly thank you for all that you've done for us. All right, back to the script. And next week, we will honor 865 students who have earned AP Scholar with honor or distinction designations from the College Board. That means they earn a 3.25 or a 3.5 on their AP exams. They have their initial college credit as well.
We also recognize in Orange County Public Schools the value that arts play in the lives of our students. And we are proud to announce that OCPS had the highest percentage of students participating in visual and performing arts among the five largest school districts in the state. And once again, we were recognized as one of the nation's best communities for music education by the National Association of Music Merchants Foundation. This award highlights districts that demonstrate outstanding achievements in efforts to provide music access and education. Now, I would be remiss if I didn't pause to point out that the reason we've been able to provide these valuable arts programs is because of the generous support and commitment of our community. In 2018, an overwhelming 84% of voters approved the extension of the one mill property tax. I want to say that again. 84% of voters voted yes to continue the increased one mill property tax. Where does that happen? It happens here. It happens in a community that believes in its students and supports its school district. In 2020-21, that one mill generated more than $161 million. That equates to 1,165 teachers, counselors, and social workers whose positions would have gone unfunded by the state, therefore vacant. If it weren't for this community's support, your support, if it weren't for our hotel industry and the incredible theme parks and the vast amount of tourist taxes that we're able to collect, and the vast amount, I should say, of property taxes from all of those theme parks, we wouldn't have had those teachers, we wouldn't have had those programs. So you can clearly see the positive impact that one mill has had on our students. And we are so hopeful that in August 2022, voters will once again support a four-year renewal of that one mill property tax.
Indeed. Proceeds from the one mill also support our accomplished athletic programs. Last year, we had a number of Florida High School Athletic Association state champions, including East River High School girls bowling as the academic team champion, Dr. Phillips boys basketball champions, and Winter Park High School competitive cheerleading champions. As part of our commitment to college and career readiness, the district offers a variety of choices to students. Our Orange Technical College, which focuses on career and technical education, enrolled more than 53,000 students across its five campuses and programs at 20 high schools and 37 middle schools. And this year, we also introduced two new magnet programs, the Wekiva High School Academy of Culinary Arts and East River High School First Responders Academy, bringing our total of magnet programs to 46. We also started a Junior Reserve Law Enforcement Program. This is a collaboration among OCPS, Valencia College of Public Safety, Orlando Police Department, and the Orlando Regional Realtor Foundation. Freshmen and sophomores at Jones and Lake Nona High Schools will have their opportunity to make a difference in their own community and gain a better understanding of how law enforcement protects public safety. This program was the brainchild of Cliff Long from the Orlando Regional Realtors Foundation, and I want to thank him for bringing this idea to fruition and providing funding. Thank you, Cliff. Also this year, three high schools, East River, Evans, and Windermere, began offering new time block schedules similar to what students experience in college. I told you some good things can come from a pandemic, more than hair color. So here's what happened. Three of our high schools are piloting. We wanted our high school students to have similar options like they are in college. So, for example, they can the high school can offer 10 class periods, but students only need to select 7 periods. And so they can choose the hours when they have classes, such as early morning or late afternoon, or even have a long break in the middle of the day for an apprenticeship or employment.
Well, we're excited about this new pilot, and it was the brainchild of the superintendent and her cabinet, and we're really anxious to see how it turns out. I think that additional flexibility for our students is going to be invaluable, as we've seen how the changes from the pandemic have changed our work schedule. And in some ways, it's been a positive discovery. I think we're going to find the same with our students, so congratulations on that. Earlier in the program, Vice Chair Gould recognized our 2021 Stellar Award winners. These individuals represent our exceptional employees across our district. In our annual report, you can also read about other staff members and teams who, day in and day out, raise the bar among their peers in education.
And also supporting our student educational needs is our talented operations division. We have one of the largest food and transportation systems in Central Florida. We told you earlier about the 44 million grab-and-go curbside meals we distributed during the pandemic. On average, we serve more than 213,000 meals per day and transport more than 70,000 students to and from school. It's been a challenge, a huge challenge during the pandemic, to hire enough bus drivers and others to meet the demand. The problem is not limited to Central Florida, as much of our nation is facing similar shortages. But I want to thank and recognize again all of our support personnel for the tremendous work that they do, Ron.
On a positive note, our students continue to learn in state-of-the-art facilities. Thanks to the 2014 halfpenny sales tax renewal, we've opened 59 new schools and renovated or replaced 132 schools since the sales tax program began in 2002. More recently, we've opened, replaced, or renovated 10 schools in 2020 and 5 in 2021, including 2 new high schools this year, Lake Buena Vista and Horizon High School. An additional 12 new schools are scheduled for completion in the next 5 years. And let me comment that these schools aren't just about building pride or feeling good that you're in a new school. It is because of these new facilities that we were able to do things that Dr. Vasquez talked about. Our MERV 13 filters, that might sound Greek to you, but what they've done is cleaned and filtered our air far better than anything that we had before, and far better than most schools in most districts across the state. And it was only possible because we had already spent so much money upgrading our schools. The same is true, Dr. Jenkins has pointed it out, with our digital devices and our Wi-Fi connections and all of the things that we have in our schools that make them safer and made us better prepared for this pandemic. The value of these new schools is absolutely priceless.
I would agree, and because we live in Central Florida, we may not realize it, but across this nation, there are districts with schools that are crumbling with outdated systems and in need of desperate maintenance repairs. So we are very grateful to this community for that support. I'd like to share something else about our building program, which since 2011 has been under the direction of our Chief Facilities Officer, John Morris. Some of you know John passed away last week. His legacy will resonate throughout our community for generations to come, through not only the buildings he built, but also the people he inspired.
I've personally known John for many, many years, dating back to my time as a county commissioner. John worked for the county overseeing huge community projects such as the Orange County Convention Center and the new Amway Arena before joining OCPS to oversee the largest construction program and renovation program of any school district in the state. John had a tremendous and lasting impact on our students and our community through those projects. And through his kindness, he also had a lasting impact on all of us who were blessed to know him.
So we
to his family, our prayers continue to go out to the family and his co-workers in this difficult time for all of us.
He was a good man. So we started off this morning promising to give you an honest appraisal of our school district. This includes our successes as well as our challenges. And COVID-19 certainly brought unprecedented challenges. As much of the world focuses on the physical illness of COVID-19, we as a district are equally focused on the academic challenges presented by the so-called COVID slide. Unlike the familiar summer slide, which describes a learning loss while school is out of session, the COVID slide reflects unfinished student learning. Considering the general effect this impact can have on the life of a child, one can easily ascertain the importance and necessity of accelerating our students. Additionally, we have, number one, increased our focus on social-emotional learning, allowing us to offer monthly mental health and wellness courses for students in grades 6 through 12. We created the OCPS Supports Initiative, which reduces the gaps and provides services for families based upon their specific needs. Number three, we ensured every child has a digital device and, if needed, a mobile hotspot, thank you, T-Mobile, for access to learning anywhere and anytime.
Thank you, Dr. Jenkins. Let me close today's address by sharing my gratitude to you, to your administration, to my fellow board members, to our incredible teachers and administrators, and our dedicated and amazing education support specialist who, under the leadership of Mr. Pollard, have done a phenomenal, unrecognized, and sometimes unsung heroes that we have. We have worked together and we've accomplished so much. And today we've tried to highlight those accomplishments as well as those challenges. But let me share my personal thoughts. I'm bolstered by the work that we've done over the past 2 years and our commitment to the work we're going to continue to perform in the years to come. Despite the challenges that we faced as a result of the pandemic, we at OCPS have and will continue to maintain our focus on every one of our students as we work to ensure that they become respectful, productive members of our society. I look forward to the future with great enthusiasm and great confidence because our students are resilient. They are determined. They are capable of attaining their dreams and so much more. And with your support, we can and we will empower them to become the best generation. As we approach the holiday season, we express our gratitude for the patience and support you've extended to OCPS as we have and will continue to navigate these unprecedented times. And we express our gratitude for the kindness and generosity you as a community have shown to our students, our families, and our staff. On behalf of the School Board of Orange County, thank you. Thank you for your commitment to Orange County Public Schools and to our entire team, to our 206,000 students, to our 24,000 employees. As you enter this season of Thanksgiving, may you find many causes and many reasons to be thankful. May you also look for every opportunity to be patient and kind. May God bless you, and may God bless our 206,000 students, our 24,000 employees, and our community. Thank you for joining us today.